Hello students, today again we are continuing with biology class 12th new syllabus chapter number 11 enhancement of food production. Today is the 11th lecture of the chapter enhancement of food production. Okay, in this chapter we have started with the part microbes in human welfare. In this chapter the topics that are deleted for this academic year are 11.2 plant breeding, 11.3 tissue culture, 11.4 single cell protein and 11.6 animal husbandry. Okay. The topic that we have studied in our last lecture was microbes in sewage treatment. We have studied about the different steps of the process of sewage treatment. Okay, preliminary treatment, primary treatment, secondary treatment, and then finally we have studied about the tertiary treatment. Today, we are going to study about microbes in energy generation. Okay, we are going to study about microbes in energy generation. Many developing countries are encouraging for installation of biogas plants to meet out the requirements of energy. Okay, there are many developing countries, and in one of those developing countries India is also included. These developing countries are encouraging for installation of biogas plant. Okay, biogas plant is this equipment that is used for energy generation. So biogas plants are installed so as to meet the requirements of energy. Biogas is used as a domestic and industrial fuel. It can be used as a domestic fuel as well as industrial fuel. It is non-conventional and renewable source of energy and is obtained by microbial fermentation. We can say that biogas is a non-conventional, okay, and renewable source of energy, and it is obtained by microbial fermentation. Moving on to the composition of biogas, which is very very important question for your board exam point of view. Okay, composition of biogas, 2 marks question it is. Biogas is a mixture of methane, okay, methane 50 to 60%, carbon dioxide 30 to 40%, then hydrogen sulfide 0 to 3%, and other gases, that is carbon monoxide, nitrogen, hydrogen in traces. This composition vary depending upon the raw materials that are used. But the standard composition that you have to remember is methane 50 to 60%, carbon dioxide 30 to 40%, and hydrogen sulfide 0 to 3%, and other gases such as carbon monoxide, nitrogen, hydrogen in traces. Okay. Then we will study about the raw materials that are required for the generation of biogas. We require different types of waste material such as animal dung, poultry waste, plant waste, human excreta, industrial waste, domestic waste. All such type of waste are required for the production of biogas. When I say plant waste, it includes husk, grass, weeds, etc. Industrial waste includes sawdust, waste from food processing industries, etc. Domestic waste include vegetable peels, waste food materials, etc. So this all are the kinds of raw materials that are used for the production of biogas. We can say any waste, plant waste, animal waste, domestic waste, agricultural waste, municipal waste, forestry waste, etc. All the commonly used are all commonly used for biogas production. Now, there are some key points that need to be remembered. That is, cattle dung is most commonly employed substrate for the production of biogas. We can say that cattle dung is the most commonly used, means it is most commonly used, it is most employed substrate for the biogas production. Biogas is highly inflammable and is used as a source of energy. We can say that it is a rich source of cellulose from the plants. Okay, biogas is a rich source of cellulose from plants. Now, let us study about biogas plant. Okay, we will study about the biogas plant where biogas is generated. The most widely used, most commonly used models of biogas plants are KYIC and IARI. Okay, what do you mean by KYIC? It means Khadi and Village Industries Commission, and IARI means Indian Agricultural Research Institute. The technology of biogas production was developed in India mainly due to the efforts of these two places, that is IARI and KYIC. So you need to remember IARI is Indian Agricultural Research Institute and KYIC is Khadi and Village Industrial Commission. Okay. So biogas plant, what do you mean by biogas plant? We can say that we can define it as the digester used for biogas production is called as biogas plant. Okay, the digester that we use for the biogas production is called biogas plant. We can say that typical biogas plant, we just put it in cattle dung as a raw material. We use cattle dung as a raw material. It consists of digester and a gas holder. A typical biogas plant is consisting of a digester and gas holder. Digester is made up of concrete bricks, cement or steel. All the digesters can be made up of concrete brick. You can see here these are bricks. Okay, concrete bricks, cement or steel. There is a cylindrical gas holder or a gas tank above the digester to collect gases. Okay, gases are collected in the cylindrical gas holder. Digester has a side opening into which raw material as a cow dung is fed. You can see here, this is the side opening into which raw material is fed. Okay, raw material is fed into this. Raw material such as cow dung and water, both are mixed in equal proportion, 1:1 proportion, and it is fed into the digester. Okay, this is digester. So, digester is partly buried in the soil. So you can see here digester, it is a concrete, it is made up of concrete, it can be made up of a concrete brick, cement or steel. It has a gas holder above it to collect the gases. It has a side opening for the collection of raw material in which cow dung and water is mixed in 1:1 proportion, equal proportion I can say. Okay, and a gas holder for collection of gases. You can see methane, carbon dioxide. All the biogas, all the components of biogas are collected here and finally a biogas is released. So this diagram is also very important from your exam point of view. Many times diagrams are asked in paper. Biogas plant diagram can be asked for 3 marks. Okay, it is a question of 3 marks. Now we will study about the biogas steps. Okay, anaerobic digestion involves 3 processes. The biogas process is often divided into 3 steps, hydrolysis, acidogenesis, methanogenesis. Okay, where different groups of bacteria are responsible for different steps. Now we will see one by one the different steps. First one is hydrolysis. The other name for hydrolysis is solubilization. Hydrolysis is also known as solubilization. In initial stage, raw material such as cattle dung is mixed with water in equal proportion. I already told you this, to make slurry which is then fed into the digester. This raw material is mixed and it is fed into the digester. In the digester, anaerobic hydrolytic bacteria such as Clostridium and Pseudomonas both act and they hydrolyze carbohydrates into simple sugars, proteins into amino acids, and lipids into fatty acids. Okay, so hydrolysis or solubilization is a process in which raw material is mixed in equal proportion and it is then fed into the digester. In the digester, anaerobic hydrolytic bacteria such as Clostridium and Pseudomonas are acting, and in that carbohydrates are converted to simple sugars, proteins are converted to amino acids, and lipids are converted to fatty acids. Next step is acidogenesis. When I say acidogenesis, in this stage, facultative anaerobic acidogenic bacteria and obligate anaerobic organisms convert simple organic material into acids like formic acid, acetic acid, H2 and CO2. Third step is methanogenesis. This is the last stage in which anaerobic methanogenic bacteria like methanobacterium, methanococcus, converts acetate, hydrogen and carbon dioxide into methane, carbon dioxide and water and other products. So this is the last step of methanogenesis. Here methanobacterium and methanococcus are converting acetate, water and carbon dioxide into methane, carbon dioxide and water. These are all the reactions. Acetic acid is getting converted to methane, formic acid getting converted to methane, and carbon dioxide and hydrogen getting converted to methane. Now we will see the advantages or benefits of biogas, which is again an important question from your board exam point of view. Advantages of biogas. It is cheap, safe, renewable source of energy. Biogas is very cheap. It is, we can use it, we can make it as at a very affordable price. So we can, it is a one of the advantage. It is cheap, safe and renewable source of energy. It can be easily generated, stored and transported. This is the second advantage, that it is very easy to generate, very easy to store and very easy to transport biogas. Next advantage is it can be used for domestic lighting, cooking, street lighting as well as small scale industries. Next, it burns with blue flame and without smoke. So that means it does not create any pollution. Okay, so it is very much helpful that it is burning with blue flame and without smoke. It helps to improve sanitation of the surrounding. Okay, since cow dung is used as a raw material, so everywhere the cow dung that are laid are used, are consumed in the preparation of biogas. So we can say that it improves the sanitation of surrounding. Next is it is eco-friendly and does not cause pollution. It is said to be very eco-friendly gas and it does not cause any pollution and imbalance of the environment. Sludge which is left over is used as a biofertilizer. The remains that after the generation of biogas, the remaining material that is sludge, that is also used as a biofertilizer. So from starting till end, everything is used, so that this all are the advantages of biogas. Very important, I will repeat once again. It is cheap, safe, renewable source of energy. First point, it can be easily generated, stored and transported. Second point, it can be used for domestic lighting, cooking, street lighting as well as small scale industry. Third, it burns with blue flame and without smoke. Next is it helps in improving sanitation of the surrounding. And the last point is it is eco-friendly and does not cause pollution and imbalance of the environment. Thus, sludge which is left over is also used as a fertilizer. So, biogas is a very, very important gas and it has many advantages. So, this question is also very important from your exam point of view. Okay, thank you for today. We will continue this chapter in our next lecture.